What dynasty?
No, you say it.
It's your favorite day. It's my favorite day. It's my uncle's, my grandma, my aunt, my whoever. It's Podcast Monday. Woo!
It's your sound effects.
Woo!
So, topics of the week. We have your fan still going on, first of all.
Oh, sorry.
You gotta turn off like I did, dude.
We're gonna be hot bosses together.
Yes. So we got YCS Monterey, followed by the new BA card announcement, followed by everybody's favorite subject, ARG. Then some product news, including special editions and Megaton list. Sort of, kind of. So let's get started. So YCS Monterey.
Podcast. Is it Monterey or is it? Yeah, it was Monterey.
Yeah, don't say Mexico, dude. That's.
No, I was gonna say Montreal.
Yeah. Montreal is Canada.
Yeah, so.
Canada.
I don't know, dude. I just did like one so the coverage was pretty butts. But I saw the venue picture, dude. That thing on the left looks sick.
Yeah, their picture is really like their venue looks really nice.
This is the thing on the left, that water thing bucket.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. So, what is it? Dude, I know people don't like ARG, but I have to cover it, Yu-Gi-Oh! News.
Ooh.
Technically.
What is it? So, there's only 375 duelists there. Must be nice.
That's a YCS too, right?
Yeah.
It's always around that number for Southern California, so like, Central America.
Oh no, we just like bagging on ARG. No, ARG's not that bad, we just like messing with it. So I'm just talking chat. But top 16 deck list. There was 5 Necroz Clowns, 4 Pure Necroz, 2 Shadal Clowns, 2 Burning Abyss, 1 Cleaford Stun. I don't even know what's Stun. Well, but for sure, 1 Cleaford Turbo. Vroom vroom. And 1 Stellar Knight Sephiroth.
Alright. I think I have an idea on what Cleaford's stun is.
No, that's
traps.
I'll tell you in a bit.
Oh well, go ahead.
But yeah, we have the top 3 deck lists. I couldn't find the 4th. So the only American in top 3, Ben Leverett, with Necroz Crowns. So going over the deck list, don't say it. I know people are gonna say it. Don't say it.
Same deck, different day.
SSDD or SDDD.
Same deck, different day.
Yeah, I heard about Clown Heroes, but regionals is an iffy subject in my opinion.
Yeah.
But I'm going over this list first, and I'll go over chat a bit. We got 3 Valk, 3 Unicorn, double Brio, double Klaus, 1 Decisive Arm, 1 Trish, 1 Cataster. For the regular monsters, it's triple Manju, triple Senju, triple Damage Juggler, triple Trick Clown, 1 Hat Tricker, 1 Great Sorcerer, 1 Dance Princess, 1 Shrit, triple Cycles, double Kaleido, double Mirror, 1 Prep, double Rota, and a Foolish. So a quick note, that's Mexico. This was taken from the card guides. He thought the deck would do bad because it's not ARG format, but it actually did pretty well.
So he didn't believe in his deck before he came to the event?
Yeah.
You gotta believe, that's like the number one thing, man. Believe.
Oh, dude, we're not from Mexico. We're from the place next to Mexico.
From Cali.
Yeah. But, he played the same deck in Toronto, but instead of Decisive Arm, he didn't play Decisive Arm, he played the extra Hat Tricker. He had the Cataster for to bring back the level 4s, the Shrit, or to make 104. Yeah, no one chats. Oh, I don't know about chat. Us three aren't. Trick Clown. Yeah, triple Trick Clowns. Because he said it lets you kill the opponent in the mirror match by making Masquerade. It's instant rank 4s and BAs, but it's busting Shadals. And also, you can plus it off it using Cycle. Because it comes back.
Okay, I see that.
He doesn't like Hat Tricker because, Trick Clown's more versatile because you can tribute and stuff. But with Hat Tricker, you can only SS it. That's pretty much it. Dance Princess, they get Shrit back. And Triple Cycle because game one goes pretty long. So, thoughts on main deck? Don't say same deck, different day.
Different day, same deck.
God damn it!
I didn't say it.
Just the ratios on the clowns.
And the cycle.
I guess I can agree with that, considering it is Monster Reborn, but I feel like there's not enough recurability with Shurit. Maybe if there was double Shurit, I would agree with it.
I have to say, the triple cycle is pretty smart in this build, because he's running the clowns, which is free food. So you can always make a Valk, which Valk and Unicorn are like win conditions in Necros, and they're pretty much free food, essentially.
And then Valk can tribute off the clowns like normal, yeah, and get free draws.
I believe this deck list will be really good in the mirror, because you're gonna outpace them with Valk. You're just gonna go like Valk, 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 Valk every turn, and they can't do anything about it.
What I kind of don't agree with is Gungnir in the side.
Oh, like, wait, I haven't got there yet.
Oh, well.
Sorry. I'm just talking about extra deck main deck for now.
No, I mean, in general, okay. But yeah.
Kataster. I mean,
Kataster is good. That's a good card. Like, you discard it and then you bring back the shirt.
He's not playing. Instead of playing the regular version, he's playing the ritual version. So
yeah, it's a lot faster too, because for the regular version you have to banish it, and that usually requires like something like the spell to bring it back. I mean, yeah, that is quite a common scenario, but that needs to be in the grave before you can banish it. So it's a little harder to pull off.
Mm-hmm.
Note though, I was playing with the Exa. If you draw, it's like pretty dead. You're fucked.
Yeah.
Like, at least with Kataster, you can just discard. That's the better.
Yeah. That's why I feel Kataster is a little better than Exa.
Yeah. Okay. Fair enough.
Okay. That's it for main. Agreed.
Yeah.
Dennis.
That's it. Yeah. Okay,
so going to the side. Side deck also pretty generic. Triple Veiler, double Danko, one Gungnir, triple Shared Ride, double MST, double Decree, and one Vandies. Notes, the Effect Veiler for Mirror Match pretty much, the Dankos for BAs, and for Necross just to stop emptiness, because no one believes in gentleman agreements anymore.
Yeah, I guess, yeah. I mean, I'd mean it, but okay.
Gungnir, he says, not really a combo card. So he's not main deck, and pretty much only for the Cleaver match because of the popping effect.
Mm-hmm.
Mistakes. MST is actually for like mistakes and a bit for Klee, but surprisingly the Kree is not for Klee. It's for BA and Rogue only, because Klee can get rid of it with Carry and Helix and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And Vandy's only good in Mirror.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I wonder how much Shadal's he played. That's all.
I also disagree. Vanity is only good in Mirror because it does stop BA pretty cold. Like, unless they're fully set up, which you shouldn't set the Vanities, they're going to stop you pretty cold with the back row, regardless. So, Vanities is that card that can stop, like, a lot more matchups than he thinks, or than he notes, but I can see why he has that mentality, because he doesn't really set up a lot of back row.
Maybe it's just he feels that he wants people to side it out, so he just has it there just to side it out. He doesn't need it to win, I guess you can say.
Yeah,
you
know? I see.
Yeah.
And then I just don't agree with Gungnir in general most of the time, because like, you can just replace her with another MST. And it's almost the same thing, because Gungnir is a waste of resources in the long run. And you just tend to minus more just due to the fact that you're pitching more valuable Necroz monsters. So I'd rather just not run Gungnir at all if that's possible.
Okay. That's all I have.
Okay, then extra deck pretty much. Last thing, pretty generic. It's Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon, double Herald, Abyss Dweller, a Castell, double Degusto Emerald, one Diamond Direwolf, one Exiton, one Cowboy, one Masquerade, one this is right, this isn't right. Steel Storm Roach.
Oh, instead of Diamond. Yeah. Or Crab King.
Steel Storm. They don't has.
Yes! Then the trapeze. This looks off. I don't know why. Oh my god, it's wrong. I remember it being a double abyss. Sorry.
Booy, booy, booy. Booy, booy. You had one job.
Fired.
Hey, now with 5%, 5% less mistakes. I would have missed the main deck too. At least I spotted this shit.
Well, what was the second abyss dollar for?
For the BA matchup.
No, I meant like, what's getting cut?
Give me a second. He didn't play the potato.
Oh, diamond.
Yeah.
The Trinity.
And wrap.
Oh, wrap.
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe the wrap's good. Maybe wrap's bad. I can't really tell.
But yeah.
Wrap is straight out of Compton.
Straight out of Compton. I do agree.
Rap bro name Ice Cube from a sick dope kid.
Dang. Relax.
Going hard.
Relax.
He's going berserk. Okay, no one got it.
That's a big thing though. They didn't have Crab King.
So no,
that's why you see
out.
Like one Turbo Klee top 16.
Yeah, no one has tower out. Oh yeah, this one does because that's armor.
Guys, I'm gonna tell you right now, best tower out is Santa Claus.
I guess.
Best tower out. Volcanic Queen comes second, but best tower out is definitely Santa Claus.
Yeah, this is pretty much it. Any last thoughts?
No thoughts. Move on.
So, the next two deck lists I got from the same YouTube channel is from Jesus Alvarado. Unfortunately, they're both in Spanish. I have no idea what they're saying. So,
what is this moon speak?
Bien. Everything bien.
But yeah, this is actually a unique version of Cleese. You'll see in a bit. So he had two scout, one triple helix, triple carrier, triple shell, double perform pal trapolix, one stealth, one monolith, one tower. Tower's not bad. There's no tower. One disc, one pendulum dragon, double Vecvaler, triple maxi, triple Summoner's Art, double MST, double storm, double chalice, one wavering eyes, one hidden armory, one sacrifice, one enemy econ, you know, enemy controller, yeah. One lose one turn, one vanities, one skill drain, one warning, and one reclate.
I mean, it's pretty standard.
Is this the stun deck?
Yeah, quote unquote stun. And first of all, ask Law. Law will go in pretty hard for towers out. You need two of them, two monsters on the field.
You need to leave two monsters on the board, like a dumbass.
But yeah, this is actually pretty, like, I'll expect more traps, but this is more spell heavy.
Yeah, it's. I don't know where the stun comes from, but okay.
No, that's why I put it in quotes.
Yeah.
Because, like, there's, like, they have chalice and the generic traps.
I feel like this. Go ahead.
I was guessing it was just one of stun cards, like Vanity, Skill Drain, and Solemn, but I mean, like, this seems like turbo stun. Like, it's trying to get through the cards in its deck as fast as it can, so that it can get the stun cards, quote unquote. But there's only one of for each stun, so I don't even see how this is a stun deck.
Yeah, I feel like he was probably trying to prepare more for the BA matchup with the Storms, since it just won Toronto, I believe, right?
Yeah.
It won Toronto, right?
Yeah.
So. I mean, coming with that mindset, I think a lot of people are bandwagons and they just all play BA. So that's why you play Storm. I mean, it's a pretty good meta choice. He came in second, so congrats to him. No other words.
I don't know. Like, at first, like, it was starting to look like Tipper when I saw the deck profile. Then I saw the one stealth and I started questioning things. But that's my personal opinion.
Yeah, I mean, I guess the shell puts in work against BA.
Oh, yeah.
Shell totally just wrecks BA. That's what Fire Lake is for, right? Then comes back.
Move on to side. We have the triple Flying Sea, double Necro Valley, double Wavering Eye, additional Storm and MST, triple Imperial Iron Wall, a Shadow Prisoning Mirror, a Soul Drain, and a Torrential. So, from what I've heard from the little Smash I know, the Tarantulas and the Claws, the Soul Drain, and the Shadow Prison for Shredals.
I don't know what the Flying Sea is. I hope he knows that if you have a Pendulum out, you can't Flying Sea.
That's where the cat comes in.
I mean, like, must be nice. If you have Cat and Scout, you should win that game regardless. You don't need Flying Sea to win.
Well, maybe against BA, but I mean, if you have BA, you should be losing. Like, they're gonna fire lake your shit like 10 out of 10 times. So Flying Sea just puts in work.
And also another thought process, like, okay, let's say you win game one. You know, for like 9% of the time, BA is gonna go first turn one. So they're gonna try up the Dante play, then you drop it.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's fair enough, I guess. I would think that double MST and no storms already enough.
So. And I think Necro Valley, Shadow Imprisoning, and Soul Drain would be enough. If it wasn't already enough, but, you know.
Yeah. No further words.
Yeah, extra deck. Not really standard. You have one Castell, one Abyss Dweller, one Ragna Zero, one Rhapsody, one Durandal, one Volcasaurus, one Gaia Dragon. Then it gets weird. You have the Maelstroke, the Korn. The Downer is understandable because Econ. Then he has Utopia and Utopia Ray. Then Menaphis, Horus, Trishula, and Mystic Sand because he has nothing else to put in.
What's the last one?
Mystical Sand.
It's just, okay.
Just a random. That's the blank.
It's because he doesn't have Exiton.
Yeah, I think he needs Exiton. Just in case.
I want to pop my own scouts.
I mean, it's just good.
Well, how would you even summon Exiton with Scout out? Would you like to tell me that?
He would do my play where I do all that stuff, then still be dumb enough to have Exiton out afterwards. But
how do you even summon Exiton with Scout out?
No, you bounce it back, but you play the Scout back again afterwards.
Oh, yeah.
The next time you work.
That's funny.
You know I would do it, dude. But Trishula, the XYZs, I mean the Synchros, because he can.
I guess.
The cat. Valor. People cry.
Yeah, no further comments.
No.
So, congratulations to second place. He uses the Dark Arts.
He uses the Dark Arts.
So first place, the deck he couldn't beat, Burning Abyss!
Yay!
Even with all that hate, he couldn't beat it.
So first place is Alan Guzman. Congrats to him. I have a picture right here. Give me a second.
Do you know if Ben Leverett lost to the Klee or to the BA?
Oh, give me a second, I can check right now. Yu-Gi-Oh! Blog. Ben Leverett lost to the Klee. What the fuck?
Well, I guess. Gungnir not good enough.
Oh my, okay, I just see the nerf. I have no idea how. He must be a god, dude. Fucking Dark Arts. But, sorry. Going to the deck list. Triple Absolute Black King Backjack. One Aelich. One Barbar. Triple Sir. One Drahig. Double Farfar, triple Graph, one Rubik, triple Skarm, Tour Guide, Foolish, Rikeki, Breakthrough, triple Fiend Griefing, double Fire Lake, triple Karmica, double Phoenix Wing, Wind Blast, a Rikeki Rake, a Skill Drain, a Warning, double the Traveler and the Burning Abyss, Torrential, and Vandies.
Like we see again, the Traveler is very prominent in this BA deck. I don't know, man. This Traveler shit is kind of getting annoying.
It's good cards.
I mean, it's the same deck. Like, nothing new in this deck. Why do you start playing Traveler now? Well, what?
I'm telling you right now, this is why they play Traveler. It's because Jinlock was a thing. Before Jinlock was even a thing, it wasn't very good to just keep summoning monsters randomly. Because that like got your resources nowhere, but now that we can handle our resources a lot better, Traveler is more prominent because it can set up even more unbreakable fields, and like you can make triple Dante off it easy now, and before then, we only had like three Burning Abyss monsters, and
no, no, no,
I guess
I meant before, like during that season, Jin wasn't legal for Nats, right? Or was it?
Yeah,
I don't recall. It was legal for Nats.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So this is the first event. The first event where Traveler was prompt was came out was after Jin came out.
Yes,
I
believe
so.
That.
Okay, my mistake.
Because the ban list came after Nats. Remember?
I thought Jin was already banned before Nats.
No, the ban list came after Nats because they were still gathering data, and they waited till all the Nats were finished.
No, I know the ban list came after Nats. I'm saying I thought Jin was banned before Nats.
No. Jin was still there. Jin was banned last ban list.
Oh, I didn't know that. Is that recent? I feel like it's been a while already.
It's that recent. It's been 3 months, or 2 months.
Oh.
2 months.
So ban list, Konami?
Yeah, where's her ban list? But yeah, Jin was a very prominent card, so there's no point leaving your stuff out for Trish. Not very good. Yeah, that's one of the main reasons why it wasn't ran. Like, it wasn't very good. And then before then, there's not enough monsters. I think it was tested before the Secret Forces came out, but like it didn't gain wind because the Secret Forces came out and became less prominent.
So everyone played, Monster BA, where like they just throw all their monsters on board.
Yeah, and then they tried to get rid of their hand as well, so.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know Jin just came out, just got banned recently. I felt like it's been a while.
It's been 2 months.
Because I haven't been Jin locked since like forever.
Since July.
I didn't get Jin locked in Nats either, so I don't know, it's been a while.
Jin lock was still there.
Okay, just okay. Maybe I just outplay them. They don't want Jin lock me, you know.
They didn't want Jin lock you.
Give me a second.
Okay.
I gotta verify this.
Yeah, it is. I just checked her now.
Okay.
Jin lock. Jin was a July.
I'm fairly certain Jin lock came.
July 16th.
July. So.
Yeah.
Okay, I gotta see it now. I just remember Laval. I don't know. It's weird. This game's weird. But we done with main deck pretty much.
Yep.
Side deck.
Yeah.
We have double Lancia, double Flying Sea, double Vandy's Fiend, double Darkhold, double Galaxy Cyclone, triple Mystique and Arrest, and double MST.
No comments. Mystique and Arrest broken.
Standard.
Lancia, Flying... maybe not Flying Sea. I don't really agree with, because Vandy's should be enough, but other than that, yeah.
I'm gonna say again, like, he probably thought BA would be prominent, so he played Flying Seas, which is not... It's not a not good card, you know. It's pretty good in the mirror.
Yeah, I agree. It's fairly good in the mirror, but I'd probably side it out for something else. Take it out for something else, but Flying Sea is still very good against BA.
He doesn't have any Shaddoll hate, so I guess he didn't think Shaddoll's going to come. I guess he thought his main deck was good enough for it with all the hand traps.
And then Shaddoll.
Hand traps with all the discard traps.
Well, the other Shaddoll hate is Vanity's Fiend.
I mean. We can get rid of it pretty easy. Breakthrough and like Dragon's Komodo, Regeki.
That is true.
Yeah, so.
Oh, then you flip Bandies.
He has no side deck hate for Shaddoll, what I'm trying to say.
I'm not joking.
Yeah. Except the double Dark Hole, I mean, I guess.
Well, I'm thinking, again, it's the Vanity's Fiend as well, but I mean, it's not as prominent as a Shaddoll side.
Yeah.
Because they have a lot of ways to get rid of it, so.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, go ahead.
Congrats to him, I guess. I think we're done with YCS in general.
Yep.
So, before that, if we go to our next subject, I would like to thank our sponsors. Where is it? Costco, where the cost is low. No, you see
gas prices are the lowest there.
No. You see, look at the webcam image. Look what I got.
Any moment now. There it is. Snacks.
So if you come to LA Regionals, I came prepared.
Snacks. For 20 viewers, we're gonna give you guys snacks. You guys asked for it.
Good luck finding us, dude.
Good luck finding us. We're not wearing Project YGO shirts, and we're not wearing black.
No, you know the kicker is, because you know how loud my voice is, right?
Yeah,
yo, was that Bui?
Yo, was that Bui?
And like, if I go to regionals, I'm gonna, once I hear Bui's shout, I was like, okay, I know where they are now.
We're not Asian, and we're not playing Shadals. Just letting you guys know.
No, dude, I tell a story happened last LA regionals or two LA regionals ago? Or like, you heard me from across the fucking room?
Yeah, I heard you from like, no, it was YCS Anaheim, man. I heard you from like across the room. And go down. Moving on.
Okay. Quick thing. Let me just. So they announced Beatrice, the whole thing. Sorry, let me just close this quick. Yes. Yes. Please work. Oh, it's not working. Oh, sorry. Let me redo this again because it freaked out.
Still setting up. Enjoy this vid.
But no, they announced Beatrice.
What is that?
The Eternal Lady. Was it rank 6, level 5, 25, 28? That's a big booty.
Yeah, she does.
It's the reverse stats of Dante.
Big Dante, right?
Yeah, Big Dante.
You need 2 level 6 monsters. You can also XYZ summon this by setting 1 Burning Abyss from your hand to your grave, and using 1 Dante monster, you control XY team as material. The material under Dante also becomes the material. Once per turn during either player's turn, except the turn discard was summoned this way, you can discard 1 XYZ material from this card, set 1 card from your deck to the grave. If this card in your possession is destroyed by your opponent's card, by battle or card effect, and send to your graveyard, you can special summon with Burning Abyss monster from your extra deck, ignoring its summoning conditions.
That's Brooks.
That's very Brooks.
Must be nice, you man!
I can see that she's very LGBT with the rainbow right there, you know? She's with the hipsters, with the, she knew America got the laws revoked, you know?
She changed her Facebook profile
to the rainbow?
She I mean, being married to Dante, she still supports LGBT. That's why she went down to hell, to make yeah. sure
that she wasn't going to come back up until, you know, the law was legal.
In everywhere.
Yeah, hell everywhere.
Earth.
Yeah, hell have nerves, exactly. So, on to serious news. Yeah, I think this card is really broken. It's very splashable, and like, you can mix Burning Abyss with anything now just because of this card. Well, not anything, but like, with Shadals, I'm saying, specifically. And being able to do it any turn is so powerful. Your thoughts, John?
Hieratix can play it.
There
you're right! Yep.
what if, they have used for it, though, is the question.
If Droolers come back, they can play it.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Oh my god, I'll be so broken. They can't come. Yeah. Rulers can't come back ever again because of this card.
And then, I think, what's it called? Minerva? That Japanese card? Anthony was telling me about this. Any deck.
Oh, you bring it up, right?
You can just use Astral Force on it because it's a light fairy. And I'm like, okay. I mean, I guess. But
Minerva is level 4, right? Rank 4?
Yeah.
Rank 4, yes. So yeah, that's too higher.
So you need to win a YCS, get the Minerva, and then you need to rank this up from to go all the way to Japan to rank it up.
Quick pretty, thing pretty pro. We say rulers because of the effect to dump a card from your deck to the grave. Not yeah. to summon it.
Not summon it, no. It's the dumping effect. It's like a Lavalva chain, pretty much.
Well, it's a Lavalva chain on either player's turn, so
I'm crack.
you can use the effect to like send something ridiculous like Shadow Dragon, and then it'll pop a face down on their card. You can use it to send Farfa. Like, I think the idea of just having a Foolish Burial on either player's turn, it's not even just Foolish Burial, it's a Lavalva chain for both players, you on either player's turn is just really broken.
Yeah.
The secondary effect is kind of cool. I mean, it's still kind of hard.
Let's listen to Bui's mom.
Yeah. It's still kind of hard to, pull it off.
No, you're not. Oh, are you?
Anyways, it's still kind of hard to pull off the second effect because, it needs to be destroyed by your opponent's card. So.
It has to be, do you have Dark Holy or something?
They have to dark hole you or crash into their bigger monster. But I mean, I guess you can get Super Dante or Virgil or regular Super Dante.
Yeah, is Super Dante pretty broke too?
No, he's all right. You pitch one to draw one, I believe. And then he can't be targeted. And
as a Leo,
when he's sent to the graveyard, you can bounce a card, I think. Let me see.
So when Beatrice dies, Super Dante comes out.
Yeah.
Some story about that. No, you killed my wife. Now I will kill you.
But he looks
you.
So aligned, though.
I think he takes Beatrice's clothing. I'm not gonna lie, he looks like he did.
No way, yeah!
I gotta change it for myself.
A little bit. Not too much.
Nothing wrong with that, dude. LGBT, man. Maybe,
you're right, dude!
Maybe he's in the, you know, she's his fake wife, you know, he's a, you know.
Virgil
yeah.
and Dante for Bud forever.
Yeah, Virgil and Dante forever.
Oh,
shoot, he is. Maybe he's into Scientology, you know, where you get fake wife for doing the religion.
Yeah, his graveyard effect is what's called random card from your opponent's hand to the grave.
Huh.
So I can proc Shadows, though, so it's not very good.
Alright. Yeah. In conclusion, broken.
It is broken. Not because of the second effect, though. It's definitely for the first effect.
Yeah. Okay. Moving on.
Let's talk about... Oh, we don't need time for sponsors. We should be fine.
We'll be fine. We don't need sponsors. Whatever, dude.
Because this one's going to be long.
Okay.
It's ARG.
Ugh.
Ugh.
It's the ban list.
So, we briefly discussed the ban list, but we didn't go in depth last time.
I don't know why they didn't just go back to Konami, man. Just conform, dude.
No, dude, they already lost their license. They can't come back.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They lost their license.
No, I meant, like, just come back to Konami. I meant, like, ban list-wise. Just use Konami's list.
I would like to skip it, but it's news. So, let's go. Ban list time.
Get so, fast. We're losing viewers.
Quick ban list. They banned Regeki and Towers. For Regeki, the reasoning is it's a very swingy card. It can steal games that otherwise would not be winnable. Thoughts about that for Regeki?
It's a second card and shouldn't be played at all.
I think, in general, ARG doesn't like
randomness?
Luck. Oh. Luck, yeah, RNG. They don't like luck in the game. That's what they're trying to do here. They're trying to make the game more like skill. But I think, obviously, they're trying to cater to competitive playing. So, but FYI, I hope ARG knows this, but only 10% of Yu-Gi-Oh! Is competitive. 90% isn't, like, super competitive. So, I mean, if you're targeting 10%, good for you. You know, you're losing 90% of your profits, you know? So, these statistics are not true, but I know the higher side is on the casual side. So, yeah, that's how I feel overall.
Okay, so the reasoning for Towers is pretty hilarious in my opinion. The first part is understandable, it does not allow your opponent to play the game. But the second reason, easiest way to fix Clefairy Turbo.
I mean, that's true.
It's the only way to play Clefairy Turbo, dude.
No, this is what you do with Clefairy Turbo. You don't play it. That's what they're saying.
Yeah, I mean,
it's like, don't play Clefairy Turbo or you're a jerk.
Yeah.
Well, I agree with them there though, but you know, I like to get Towers get banned. It's kind of stupid.
So you just. So now you take out your Jhin outs, your Tower outs, you just.
Oh yeah, true. Your Trish outs too? No, you don't even play Lancia anymore.
That's pretty much it for banned. To the limit. So they had Unicorn to 3 and they put it back to 1. It's the strongest and most flexible card in Necroz. A floodgate card that is easily summoned time and time again. Necroz are still too strong.
Hold on a sec. Floodgate card? I mean, every single time I see that card, it's not that big of a deal to me. But
I think in Shadals it is, though.
Oh, in Shadals. I totally forgot.
Yeah, the reference to Shadals, because Shadals is like not an existent deck. in ARG format.
I totally forgot about that.
Yeah, they're trying to revive it. So, I mean, yeah.
Okay, no, BLS wants to just repeat towers. Why? Two reasons. Does not allow your opponent to play the game. And easiest way to fix cleat for turbo. Okay.
Yep.
But going back to Unicorn, they just want to bring Shadows back.
Yeah, I mean, since Noden's coming out, I mean, it's pretty smart. But I don't know.
That reminds me of a ruling. You can't shred using... if you Norden a shred, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you can. It works, but you can only summon a Clisolus.
Yeah.
Or a Trish. No, or no, a
just the calls.
Dude, you can summon a Gungnir.
What? Yeah. Oh my god, you're three. Right!
Best play, man.
Yeah, but okay. The other limited card is Trishula, Dragon of the Ice Barrier. Little impact on the TCG meta as a whole due to its inaccessibility in most decks at the moment. Wow.
That's I think it's pretty good.
Lie.
I think it's a pretty good card.
That is a total lie because due to an inaccessibility in most decks at the moment, isn't Globe Bulb at 3 over there?
Yeah.
Like, and then there's Clowns.
Yeah, Clowns too, yeah.
So Clowns and Globe Bulb. And Mathman, oh wait, what's that Mathman at again?
Still 3.
So yeah, there's Clowns, Mathman, and Globe Bulb. That's an easy Trishula right there.
I mean, it's same thing over here. So Trish is, I think it's just, I don't know, man. It's,
I think
it's same here.
That statement is a little BS, but I mean, I do agree that it has less of an impact than it did before, so.
That's pretty much it for the limit, then. Man, there's a lot of semi-limits. Here we go. Compulse the two. Powerful, but bad against Necroz, Klee, and Cosmos. So, it wouldn't hurt because this game's no longer as extra deck based. Have yeah.
No comment. Angry.
Yeah.
One for one, make Synchrons and Infernoids better.
I don't agree. Okay.
wait. One second, actually, on compulsory. So they bring it back to 2, but they still want the Shadows to be better. I mean. That seems a little contradictory.
Oh. Yeah, Necros don't play traps, so... Yeah, they're trying to make more Necros-Chadals matchups, I guess.
Okay, I guess. But, I mean, that card still counters Shadals pretty hard. Yeah. Not too hard, but pretty hard. Go ahead, Bui.
Bubble Man. It used to be limited, now it's semi. There's enough defensive cards to stop Bubble Man, like the OTKs and stuff, and they thought heroes needed a boost.
I didn't even know it was limited. I don't see why, but okay.
No, because they had, like, because Stratos at 1.
Oh, that's Stratos, that's right. Yeah. Forgot about that.
That's pretty much it.
That's it, yeah.
I'm not really a big hero guy, so I don't really know anything else. El Shaddos to 2. Boost Shaddos, not too much of a negative impact in format.
Yeah, I agree.
This should have been... Wait, no, the Constructs at 3 again, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, then I agree with El Shaddos to 2, because, yeah, reasons.
Monster Gate for the Infernoid boost, and it can be a 2 because Royal Magical Library is banned.
I don't know why they're trying to give more power to Infernoids, man. Fuck that deck. They're trying to get rid of RNG, but they're putting more RNG back in? Like, I don't understand.
That's a little contradictory.
Yeah, what's you guys trying to do here, you know?
Okay, I think that's it for semi-limited. And then, back to 3, the Breed Dragon, back to 3, just for synchros. It's not as broken as Wolfborg or Tear.
Okay, fair enough.
Rescue Rabbit from 2 to 3, nothing to do in current format.
Come on, Equid Dino Rabbit, Wolves.
Oh my god.
Dude, Evil Sorophion, best counter to all decks, right?
Shut up! I'm out. You pushed the wrong buttons, John.
Okay.
Track to 3 because they had Gorza 3 and it's a stronger card. Might as well have Track.
No comment.
And Moral Tech 3 encourages interacting with the opponent and promotes strong decision making. Quote unquote.
I like a Moral Tech 3. I mean,
it should have been a 3 here.
I don't know about that, but.
Yes, give me back my Moral Tech.
Maybe yeah, 2.
I feel like this is the only reason why people want to play ARG, because of Moral Tech. And, I mean, ARG's. I hope ARG's plan is to make money, you know, so they want to attract players. So I think Moral Tech attract players and Rescue Rabbit attract players. Because all the other stuff they did not attract any players. So, yeah.
I have this weird thought. What if ARG is actually working for Konami by testing out these ban lists?
I'm pretty sure Konami would have given them their license then.
That was like some under the table shit.
Oh, like, we're gonna make an enemy, like how PC, like, Windows made Apple survive, because then they wouldn't be monopolized. Yeah.
And then they won't
get sued. We need you, yeah, we need you to be alive.
That's funny.
We'll comment. Same thing.
Like, on this comment on the whole ban list, it's like they didn't really have any focus other than, let's hit Necroz a little more and Turbo.
Yeah, that's the word I'm looking for. No lack of focus.
Like, at least with some of our ban lists, we have focus. Like, the Genlock. Definite clear hit because that needed to be gone. The Volvo chain because stupid stuff was coming in the future, and I think they were all just boost from there on out. So I mean, they just hit the big stuff, and that was pretty much it for our ban list.
Yeah,
it's a little more focused than this one.
Yeah, that focus was like, oh, let's let people play. You know, let's not hit any deck, but let's get rid of some problems, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, ultimately, like, no one likes their decking hit, and what ARG is doing is, like, they're beating around the bush, you know? Like, are you gonna hit it or not? So, you're either gonna do it or you're not gonna do it, because if you do half-ass, it's like, this is what happens. So.
And then it's also the fact that they update, like, every month, so
yeah,
that gives no one time to test.
Yeah. Which I don't agree with that, because they control the market. But it doesn't matter to us, because we're from West Coast, so... Yeah. Continue on, boy.
About that, ARG sponsor me, guys. I'm leaving.
Shit. Shit.
Hey, guys. Say goodbye to Bunny, and say goodbye to me.
Yeah,
this is now Bui stream.
the layout starts changing. ARG West
Coast. ARG West Coast. I look like a peace stream. It was all a ruse.
It was all a ruse.
One more quick announcement, update for ARG. They announced that they partnered up with DevPro. So now DevPro has an updated form. So on the next update for DevPro, they're going to use the ARG forbidden and limited list. But it's only unranked only.
I mean, like, that probably took like 1 minute of coding. All you got to do is put, don't allow this and allow this, you know?
If they get paid for it, I'm all for it. ARG wasting money on this is hilarious.
Yeah, like, that coding would probably take, like, no more than 30 seconds. Just copy and paste the list in.
And then, what's it called? You said unranked?
Yeah.
So what is even the point?
So like you practice?
You know what's on unranked all the time?
Cancer.
A bunch of troll decks and cancer. So, I don't even see the point of putting it on the ring.
No, dude, now I don't have to put testing out ARG format, the dueling network, and have someone play a regular deck.
But then you can't do matchmaking in DevPro.
You still can.
Isn't it random?
Oh yeah.
No, you can.
Isn't the pairings random? You don't get to pick who you play.
Yeah, you don't pick. You don't know
ranked, for ranked, no.
Yeah. Unranked.
You can just like kick people out and wait for your friends to come in.
Yeah, there's no lobby, like there's no, this ARG format, you know? So no. You can pick, there is?
So when you change the settings, you just change the ARG format instead.
They kick themselves out because they don't have the right deck.
No, yeah. I'm saying like, there's no control of who you're gonna play, you know?
Oh, well in general, that's...
Yeah.
You play, like I was trying to say, you're playing troll decks.
Yeah. Pretty much. So, I mean, like, that seems like a dumb idea in general, but Hey, if DevPro gets paid for it, I'm all for it. Because yeah, man, like,
good for you, DevPro. Good for you.
Good for you, DevPro. Smart business move.
Smart business move.
Partnering with ARG? Okay.
Hey, you want to partner with another streaming group that streams every Monday and Fridays? Hit me up.
Yeah. Sponsor DevPro.
No more DN.
I'll switch
to DevPro. Guys.
That's about it for ARG. So, sponsors time.
Yeah, I don't have anything. It's been a slow week, man. They didn't call me up to hit any ads.
Morton Salt again for Bui on Friday.
Jesus Christ. Oh, you understand what happened, man. I need to update that. I'm gonna upload that soon. shouts to Lay's, Doritos, Cheetos, Ruffles, Fritos, and Funyuns.
Snacks.
That's all I got in front of me.
Is that the new special edition?
No, that's from that's like one of the basic ones you get from Costco. But the what changes is the flavor of Lay's. Oh,
okay. I'm talking about on the stream, the core special edition.
Oh well, that's a good transition. Let's go into that, shall we?
Yeah, so they updated what's the promos for core. Core standard edition, what's it called? Standard edition? Special edition. So, it's a reminder, it comes with two promos, one of the promo and one for the next set.
Okay.
So, they actually announced, this is pretty big, they announced Ultimaya Talilskin and Frightful Trigger, which are both Shonen Jump promos.
Oh, they should put Crab King in there. What's the Ultiman? Ultiman?
Oh, it's the Dragon.
I'll tell you.
I have it on me, give me a second, let me just change it.
Okay. Does that mean they're coming in docks, Bui?
Oh, they didn't announce that yet.
Well, I mean, I think they would be because as like OCG imports, but I could be wrong.
The picture on the deck, is that the how it looks like? The deck box? I mean, the special edition?
Yeah.
Did you stretch it out or is it that fat?
No, that's small. Oh, I stretched it out a bit.
Oh, okay, I'm like, that's...
It's a standard one, dude.
That thing looks hella fat, dude. Like, holy crap.
It's single, dude. It's like the fat angle.
I think you stretch it out. I'm like, dude,
every angle's a fat angle.
It looks like gain some weight.
Jeez, man,
hey, there's more cards at this value, $10.
Yeah, yes, that reminds me. So it's $10. The release date is December 11th of this year.
For sure.
But yeah, that's actually pretty big. Unfortunately, Europe still don't get Crab King. And then actually, Europe's getting something else. Instead, they're getting the Dimension of Chaos Advanced Edition. I don't know if it's the same or different, but it's released the 9th of December.
Maybe then they'll have Crab King.
What's in there?
They didn't say anything.
Also, is it like Core Special Edition?
Might be. I don't know. Maybe it's just a name change.
Oh, okay. Is Dimension of Chaos the next set?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Comes out in November, like how Next Challengers did.
It comes out November?
No. Like how new Challengers did.
But then the special edition comes out in December.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I thought the special edition comes out before the next set comes out.
Oh.
Huh.
That's weird.
Yeah,
You need to check the Core SC again.
Yeah, I need to double check Core.
Because right, why would you try to push an old product, special edition?
It says right here.
Oh, interesting, that's really interesting. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe they'd always do this and I just don't notice it.
No, you have a fair point.
Special edition. Yeah, I'm looking at it. It says the 5th, whatever that day was. The 11th.
When is Dimension of Chaos coming out?
November 6th.
So, November 6th?
Yeah. November, so.
Oh, November 6th. Okay.
That's about right.
Why is the core coming out? After.
A month after, yeah, it's kind of weird.
I know why now, because they're not having those cards from the next set. They're having the jump promos.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense then.
Okay. No, it says one. Oh, for the January set? Upcoming January booster set?
Wait, so it's going to come out in the January set? Whoa, that's crazy.
What's the January set? Breakers?
Oh, yeah, Bosch.
Breakers is wow. That's surprising. No wonder we get the crappy cards.
It's Bosch. The next is Bosch.
That's the prefix. It's Bosch.
The next one should be Legacy. Legacy, Brown, Revelation. on network, LeBron.
Legacy of the Bold Revolution.
Oh, yeah, that's, there you go. There you go.
Speaking of LeBron, though, the Megatins.
Oh yeah.
So, the list came out. There's like 100 something cards. Like, what is it? 100 something cards. I don't want to name them all, dude. My mouth's already dry.
I think it's more than 100, right? I think it's 287.
I don't want to say it. Probably. Where is it?
It pretty much comes out every. Do you know what's from where to where? What set to what set?
I used to. What's the one? What's the one with artifacts?
John.
That was the. What's it called? Trying to remember. Primal Origins.
Primal Origins to New Challengers looks like.
New Challengers is Monolith set, right?
Yeah. No. But, yeah.
I thought it was.
Secret. Sorry. Secrets of Eternity. My bad.
Yeah. Sexy.
Sexy.
That's the one.
Wait, is Sexy the ninth?
The one with Gungnir.
Yeah. Sorry.
Oh, the one the ninth, the last three of Barfa, right? The last three BA.
No, not the last three.
No.
That's the third set, which is 9. So that's the second to last set.
That's the one with Rubik.
No, wait.
Not Rubik. I mean the ritual one.
Yeah.
The shitty one.
First set was Graf, Skarm, Sir. Yeah. Right. Second set was
Rubik.
Ailich.
Calcab.
Yeah.
And then it was Farfa.
Right.
Farfa. Libic. Libic. There's actually 4 BA. Farfa, Libic, and the Searcher, the dog looking one.
Oh, Cagna.
Cagna, and then Malkota.
And then the one after that is Barbar.
Barbar and Dragging.
Top Decker, right?
Yeah, Barbar Dragging. That's Dragging. It.
Yeah.
But surprisingly, these cards are not included in the set. So there's no Carriers, no Helix, no Shell. No Rubik. Thank God for no towers.
I mean, I guess.
No monolith.
That card's a comment, though.
And none of the BA, I mean the UA stuff.
No, I think it's very, very interesting that I think I saw one of them. They got a rarity bump.
Yeah, no. I think they got rarity decrease actually.
Yeah, some of them got rarity bumps. If I recall.
Let's see.
But I think it's okay for them not to put the Carrier and the Helix because it was in the special edition. So it was free, pretty much. So you don't, because if you didn't get it, I mean, like, come on, what were you doing? What were you waiting for?
Yeah, like Boxy is now a super instead of a secret.
Yeah, so because the last Super Tin Megatins weren't it was card for card, right? Like regular rarity.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So this one has different rarities, so I didn't see any cards that were rarity bumped with Revelance, but I guess tell me if there's anything that you guys see.
I don't know bumps, but I know, what's it called? Angeli is in this.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Where is she? Ultra still?
That's in Prio, so.
She's still in Ultra?
Let's see, I'll look quick, I'll check.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Wait, I don't see it. Is she? Okay.
Yeah. So have fun, Madochi players. But yeah, my man here is Priest.
What?
You're pre-ordering on.
Oh yeah.
A bajillion.
Yeah, you guys looking for pre-sales of the promos? Where it's on eBay/ProjectYGO. You guys check out the prices there. You guys want to negotiate prices with us? You hit us up, and we can work something out. We're probably gonna be opening all the stuff. We're probably gonna have all the stuff ready for LA Regionals if you guys are there. Yeah, we'll probably have Denko Sekas and stuff like that. Well, most likely, because we were opening a lot, so, yeah.
Okay, I need to hit you up then. Shit.
You need Denko Sekas?
Yeah.
You need to have one.
Nah, dude, I just wait for the tins. We'll pull that shit.
Yeah. So, that's pretty much it.
That's all my topics of the week. Unfortunately, this week was a slow week. The week before was hell.
Yeah, but then we didn't even do news last week.
That was a busy week. The time we do, dude, it's like, nah.
Is there anything coming up? Any YCS coming up?
Oh, YCS Dallas!
Is that the next one? Is that really the next one?
I think so. Yu-Gi-Oh! Blah. Yeah.
Yeah, so we're gonna actually, a lot of us are going to YCS Dallas. If you guys are from the Texas area and go to YCS Dallas.
There's something before that. OTS Championship.
Thanks for ruining it, Louie.
There's the OTS Championship next week or the week after.
What's the OTS Championship?
Is it the Storm one? Is that the. I don't know. Let me see FAQs. That doesn't matter, just talk about.
Yeah, so if you guys are in the Dallas area or Texas area and go to YCS Dallas, be sure to hit us up. We're wearing a Project YGO shirt, it's black. With a white font and orange YGO, exactly like how the stream is right now. And yeah, hit us up, say hi, try to sneak some duels in between rounds. We'll be there Friday, Saturday, Sunday, flying out of there Monday. Flying in there Friday afternoon, I think. Yeah, all of us flying there at Friday afternoon from LA. Yeah, hit us up. Hit us up on the Facebook if you guys want to, if there's any cool spots or if you want to like hang out or anything, you know, because we're open to anything besides butt sex. But yeah.
How much are you opening?
We're opening a case. So that's 12 tins?
Shit.
Yeah.
What do you plan on pulling? What do you want to pull, I mean?
Money cards. I only care about money cards. Dante's, Dinko's, Shadal's.
Speaking of Shadal's, I need that back too. I'm joking.
Dang, right before the event. Oh, so, also, we'll be at LA Regionals, this coming Saturday. We'll probably be there early, so, if you guys want to hit some duels, let us know.
You want snacks?
If you want snacks, hit us up. We'll be wearing our Project YGO shirt, same font. I think we might be trying to get some white ones, Bui.
Yeah.
If our budget allows. Some new shirts for our, from some of our new members here. AKA John here. Yeah. Pretty cool stuff. White shirts. If you guys want a shirt. If you guys want a shirt, you know, hit us up. We'll probably make another one if you want to buy one. Probably be like 15 bucks, 10 bucks, 15 bucks.
I'll take top 16 for you, man.
Top 16.
No, yeah. Dude, I'm gonna hit the last round. Bear Keys there again.
Yeah. Yeah. If you want to buy shirts, yeah, let us know. We'll make an order. Awesome. It's probably going to be white on black. Our current one's black on white.
We'll see, dude. There's gonna be a video on it.
Yeah.
Maybe.
That's it. Shout out to Tony564, man, for the $1.
That's from last month.
That's last
one. Where's Test at, man? I miss Test. Test is a cheap ass, man. guys don't need shit. Alright, that's pretty much it. You want to close it up, boy?
Shouts to. Get first in. Oh, man, not to get first. God damn it. Okay. I need to card shark my way through.
Card shark?
Judge, he set that card when he put it.
But yeah,
Where it's in LA. The regional's in LA.
Yeah.
Los Angeles, question? California.
That's not 9-something-something.
90032.
The LACC.
I was gonna say my area code, dude. It was gonna be bad.
Is that the LACC?
Yeah, LA Convention Center, where Anime Expo is at. Yeah, close it out, Bui.
Shoutouts to the Chinese food. Cheap food, but it's super filling. So that's it. See you guys later. Peace. Any other questions, I'll stick around for a bit. And chat. Yep. Anything else?
Shoutouts to engineers. What did I do today at work? We're making a school, Valley High School. If you guys are from Valley High School, I'm designing the soccer field there. So if you guys end up falling and scraping your leg, it's not on me, man. I did not make that turf.
Bull.
Okay, so John, can I say bye?
Yeah, shoutouts to Bowie's mom. Always there for Bowie.
Dude, they didn't hear any of that.
I know, but you're always there for Bowie, regardless. Shout
out to Bowie's mom. Bowie's mom was like, "You need to open the fan. It's so hot in here." And he's like, "No, it's okay." And he's like, "No, it's okay." And she's like, "It's so hot."
ARG, please hire me.
And he's like, "No, I'm good." No, he goes, "No, I'm good. Mom,
windows
I'm good.
Open.
Windows open."
My parents don't know about this, man.
And yeah. That's Bowie's mom. Shout out to good engineers. Yep.
done.
Yeah. Oh, goodbye.
Yeah, I might actually I might stream tonight around 10 o'clock. I gotta film the CMO in a bit. Right. And I gotta cut some videos.
Okay.
Let's watch some misplays from Dennis. Yeah?
Yeah. Probably 10 o'clock if time allows. I'm pretty busy today. Haven't eaten dinner yet. Yeah, so
Night.
Yeah, follow me. It's probably gonna be on this is probably gonna host it anyways. Pishan's gonna host it, so I think you still get the notification, right? If you're followed to him?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
I don't know, dude. I never see it.
Should.
Yeah, okay. Alright, okay guys, bye bye.
Goodbye.
Night. Oh bye Tony. Hi, hey guys, hello Tony! Why I'm sorry, we're leaving. Oh bye.
Don't worry, dude, I'll upload this to YouTube.